Just one first moment. Hi, good morning, students. How are you? Yeah. Today's class, I'm discussing about the ultrasonics and their applications so that you can understand the principles lying the applications in various fields, such as mechanical industry, medical, and some other applications. And also, I'll try to give some question so that you can answer in the Q&A. And also, I'll conduct polling some questions which is connected to the previous concepts and attend the same. So the last time, last session, especially about the microwave oven, we conduct the quiz. There are 50% of the students are attempted the quiz exam. Around 600 students are attempted the quiz exam and submitted the assignment. Among that, the minimum score I observed around 7, maximum 10. So 9, there are number of people are there in the 9. So it's a very difficult task for me to present on the screen. There are 32 members. They acquired 10 out of 10 in the microwave oven, the exam. And I have communicated to them on Saturday. I tried to call some of the numbers, but I could not able to connect. Okay, so today's session also, it includes quiz, polling, some interactive session with you so that you can understand the concept properly. And I'll give some of the questions which are thought-provoking and try to think and apply for the next application point of view. In between the concept, I'll keep that questions so that after the end of the session, try to think about that particular questions. And I'll try to discuss one of the very interesting one. One of the tech engineer from Bangalore, he designed one smart device which is useful for the especially farmers in the tribal areas to protect snake bites. One of the tech engineers like you, he designed a smart device which is useful for the farmers, especially in the tribal areas and villages, to protect from the snake bites. So I'll throw you one more question to you at the end. Please think of and give me the answers, dropping a mail to me so that I can respond. So let us come back to the session now. I'm discussing about the ultrasonics and their applications. In this point, I'm trying to give one question. Please try to participate effectively in the Q&A. Do you observe this type of device in the market? Please give me your answer in the Q&A. Do you observe this type of devices in the market? Please give the answer in the Q&A. So most of the people are saying no, no. Some people say yes, yes, yes. Very good. Okay. Most of the people are giving the answer no, no, no. But you have seen this. Look at this. So this is nothing but ultrasonic pest repellent. This is the one you are using especially in your houses to repel insect, mice, roaches, bugs, mosquitoes, and spiders. Now my question comes to you now. How ultrasonic waves are linked to these particular insects? This is the first question I'm trying to tell you now. So let us think the first point now. How the ultrasonics related to this particular insects? So in this lecture, I'll discuss about what are ultrasonic waves, what are the properties of ultrasonic waves, how to produce the ultrasonic waves, and how to detect it. Then let's see the applications of ultrasonics in different fields. I'll try to cover the maximum number of applications in this particular session, especially in the mechanical industry, and chemical and paint industry, and the sound navigation and ranging, especially in the submarines. How the ultrasonic is usable for the diagnostic sonography methods, and how the ultrasonics especially used for the dental surgery purpose. Then some of the sensors and applications. First, let me see what are ultrasonic waves. If you observe the screen carefully, I have given a frequency scale. Our audible frequency range is 20 hertz to the 20 kilohertz. This is our audible frequency range. Clear? Less than audible frequency range, it is set with the infrasound frequencies. They are set with the infrasound frequencies. So the elephants, they communicate with each other by using infrasonic frequencies. And also the volcano eruptions that comes under infrasound frequencies. So our thing is above 20 kilohertz. The frequencies above 20 kilohertz are said to be the ultrasound frequencies. The meaning of ultra is beyond. The meaning of ultra is beyond the sound frequency, nothing but audible frequencies. They are said to be the ultrasound frequencies. So if you look at the examples of ultrasound, the bats, dolphins, grasshopper, that sense the ultrasonic frequencies. Especially for the training the dogs, especially for training the dogs, the trainer uses one of the whistle, which is called Galton whistle, which can be produces ultrasonic frequencies. So I'm concerned about the ultrasonic frequency range in this session. Clear to you? The ultrasound frequencies are above the audible range. That's said to be the ultrasound frequencies. Coming to the next point, what are the properties of ultrasonic waves? The first one is they are mechanical waves. Why mechanical waves? Because these ultrasounds, especially they're related to the mechanical point of view. That is the reason I said mechanical waves. Because the frequency is higher for the ultrasonic waves, there as a frequency is higher, so that they're associated with the shorter wavelengths. So the ultrasonic waves can also be called as shorter wavelengths. The next part is, these ultrasonic waves are longitudinal waves. They're similar to the sound waves. I repeat, the ultrasonic waves are similar to the sound waves. They're longitudinal waves. They can go for reflection, refraction, and absorption, and diffraction. So the ultrasonic waves are produces reflection, refraction, absorption, and diffraction. Now, these ultrasonic waves are having the, they possess more energy content so that they can transmit for longer distance without any attenuation. That is the reason the ultrasonic frequencies are used, because they can, the energy loss is minimum so that they can transmit for longer distances. And one more peculiar property of the ultrasonic waves is, because when a sound wave is traveling through the air medium, it produces compressions and refractions. When a sound wave traveling through the medium, air medium, it produces compressions and refractions. When the air is compressed, the densities increase. So the molecules get closer and closer, so that there are thermal collisions or collisions between the gas molecules increases the temperature. In the compression, in the refraction decreases. So the ultrasonic waves are propagating through the medium. It produces intense heating effect, means it produces huge heating effect in the material when it is passing through the medium. This is the point you have to underline. When ultrasonic waves is propagating through the medium, it produces intense heating effect, means due to the compressions in the medium, that produces more heating effect when it passing through the liquid medium. Please understand, the ultrasonic speed is greater in the case of solids than liquids, followed by the air medium. So let us come back to the one. Can we hear ultrasonic waves? Please give me your response in the Q&A. Can we hear ultrasonic waves? Please give me your response in the Q&A, everyone. People say no, 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 Monica, Kavishri, Anonymous, no, no, no. Okay, fine. Everyone give the answer is no, no, no. But why? My question is why? Why can't you hear ultrasonic waves? Please give me the response. Let me see the response. Why ultrasonic waves cannot be here? Everyone said the answer. 100% people may say answer is no, no. Very good, very good. My answer is why? Why we are not able to hear the ultrasonic waves? The answer is no, but why? This is where you have to understand. This is the point we have to understand. Now I'm trying to give the answer for this, because our eardrum, especially look at the eardrum, it is called cochlea. It is a membrane which is vibrating when the sound wave hits it. So this is the diaphragm which is going to be vibrate so that it can able to sense the sound. It is senses the sound within the audible range, maybe 20 hertz to the 20,000 kilohertz. So within the audible range, it is able to detect. But ultrasonic frequencies are more than audible range, more than 20 kilohertz. So this diaphragm may not operate for that particular higher frequencies. If it is going to be sensed, there is a this particular tissue get damaged. This is the reason we cannot hear the ultrasonic waves. Now you may ask the question, sir, what is its thickness? Right, I'm trying to give the thickness of this. The thickness is 0.1 mm. The diaphragm thickness is 0.1 mm. Its diameter is 8 to 10 mm, and its weight is around 14 milligrams. So the diaphragm thickness is 0.1 mm. So it is going to be vibrate. I hope you got the answer. This diaphragm cannot able to vibrate such higher frequencies. It is going to be spoiled if it is more than 20 kilohertz. So that is the reason we cannot hear ultrasonic waves. Very good. Now let me go for the next question. Can you guess what is the frequency of bee's wing? Please give me the answer. Can you say some number? So most of the people say no, no, no. Okay. How many times the wing get vibrated? At least can you give some number? Oh, 43,000 below hertz. They're giving some numbers. Okay, fine. Let me see this. Okay, what is the frequency of bee's wing is how many times it is going to be vibrate. This vibration comes under, let me see, 190 hertz. That means it is going to be vibrate 190. This is the maximum mosquito is 250. So this is the range it is going to be vibrate. I think you understood the point. Per second it is, per minute it is 190. This many times it is going to be vibrate. Now you may got the question now. Let us go with the polling now. Let's see the polling question now. Please give me the answer for this. I'm launching the polling. Give me the answer. What is the frequency of human heart? Please give me the answer within 15 seconds. Oh, fine, fine. Yeah, well, very good, very good, very good response. Very good, very good. Very good. More voting. Yeah, wait, good. Try once. What is the frequency of human heart? Yeah, okay, then people have responded quickly. There are 800 people got responded as of now. Fine, it reached 900. Very good. Okay, I'll stop my polling. Yes, the people have responded. Very good. The answer is the heartbeat. I'm going the general way. It is 72 to the 150. For kids, 150. Minimum range is 72. If you calculate, the heartbeat frequency is equal to number of beats per second by 60. You may get the answer 1 hertz. 1 hertz region to the 2 hertz region. It comes under infrasound. Your heartbeat comes under the infrasonic range. Now you may get the question now. Sir, we can't hear the infrasound sound, but we are able to hear the heartbeat, right?
Yes. Why it is? Think. Think.
The heartbeat comes under infrasonic. Now you are able to sense the heartbeat. Why? Please think about this. I'll give the answer later. Okay. Now. So, ultrasonic waves can be produced from the ordinary loudspeakers. Please give me the answer in the Q&A. Can we produce ultrasonic waves from ordinary loudspeaker? Please give me the answer in the Q&A. Yeah, Nagesh said very good answer. Oh, how response is so good. No. Now there is a misconception. Some people say yes, some people say no. The reason behind is the same like ear diaphragm. The ultrasound, the speaker, we cannot produce the ultrasonic waves, but not from the loudspeaker, because some people may have the misconception that if I increase the sound, it may lead to ultrasonic waves. No, you are increasing the intensity, but not the frequency. I'm bothered about the frequency. So the using the ultrasonic, the loudspeaker, the ultrasonic waves cannot be produced. Okay, we got the answer. But why it is? Let us understand the logic here. In the case of, if you look at the magnetic speaker, the speaker diaphragm like an eardrum, it is going to be vibrate. If it is vibrating more than 20 kilohertz, that diaphragm may damage, the first point. The second point is, especially in the speakers, it is associated with the inductance coil. You may study it in intermediate. For higher frequencies, the inductance is going to be very high, so that no current flows through it. That is the reason the loudspeaker cannot be produces the ultrasonic waves. This is the answer for that. Okay, now let me go with that. How to produce ultrasonic waves? Now question comes to finally, how to produce the ultrasonic waves? So we cannot produce using this loudspeaker, then how to produce? Simple logic. Ready with the polling now. Recall your previous class. I'm trying to connect to the previous session, piezoelectric effect. I'm launching polling. Please give me the answer for this. I'm launching the polling. Yes, give me the answer. What in the piezoelectric effect? Respond immediately. Recall your previous class. What in the piezoelectric effect? Oh, very good response. Very good response. 400 students responded out of 988. Very good. Most of the people had said the answer C. There are 400 students given the correct answer. The answer is, I'm ending the polling. Let us, those who have missed the classes, I'm trying to give the answer. The meaning of piezo is nothing but push. The meaning of piezo is push. Once you push the charges, when you apply the pressure, the charges are pushed out. This is said to be the piezoelectric effect. I repeat, I've taken a quartz crystal, which is a piezoelectric material. When applying the pressure, the charges are pushed out in the lateral direction. This is said to be the piezoelectric effect. Yes, now, especially for the quartz crystal, which is an anisotropic crystal, the properties are differ in different directions. That is said to be the anisotropic crystal. That is, example is quartz. This is the one. So when you're applying the pressure, the maximum amount of the field you can develop is 2 milliwatts. This is the maximum energy you can generate with the piezoelectric effect. Now, this is a piezo. When applying the pressure, the voltage is generated. Now I'm going for the inverse. The meaning of inverse is, I'm giving the electrical field, the crystal is going to be vibrate. That is said to be the inverse piezoelectric effect. I repeat, when you're applying the alternating electric field with respect to one particular direction, the crystal is going to be vibrate. That vibration is nothing in the region of ultrasonic waves. I repeat, when you're applying alternating electric field, time varying electric field across one phases of the crystal, the vibrations are produced in perpendicular direction, that is said to be the inverse piezoelectric effect. This phenomena is called as electrostriction. Electro means electric field, striction means change in length. The phenomena is said to be the change in length. When applying the electric field, there is a change in length. That is said to be the inverse piezoelectric effect. Is it clear to you? So when you're applying the alternating electric field, the crystal is vibrating. That vibration comes in the region of ultrasonics. So by using the quartz crystal, we can produce the ultrasonic frequencies. What is the maximum we can produce? The maximum is around 500 megahertz region we can produce with respect to this crystal. Here one point you have to understand is the thickness should be very less. That's in the region of millimeter. That's in the region of millimeter range only it is going to be vibrate. If you take more thickness, it cannot vibrate. I hope you understood the concept. The electrostriction is change in length due to the electric field. Now the question comes to you. Please go for the polling. I'm launching the question now. I'm launching the next question. Please give the answer. What do you mean by magnetostriction? What do you mean by magnetostriction? If you understood electrostriction, then you have to try to give the answer. What do you mean by magnetostriction? Very good answers. Please respond immediately. You are giving very good answers. You are following the concept. Very good. This is the way the students get activated. Very good response. Very good response. Please read it carefully. There is a change in length due to what factors? Is electric field, temperature, pressure, or magnetic field? The concept of electrostriction is change in length in the presence of alternating electric field. Now I'm changing the word towards magnetostriction. So there is no correction for that. Most of the people understood, but they've given the answer option C because I changed that last word. People are voted, most of the people for C answer. Okay, fine, fine. There are 870 people got responded out of 973. Now, fine. Everyone is responded. Everyone is responded. I'll stop polling. The answer is the change in length in the presence of varying magnetic field. This is said to be the magnetostriction. So electrostriction is change in length due to the electric field. I'm using magnetostriction is nothing but the change in length due to the variation of magnetic field. Now, sir, how can you understand? Yes, I'm trying to show one of the animation so that you can understand. Look at this. What is going to be happening here? The magnetic dipoles get rotated due to the varying magnetic field. The magnetic dipoles, I'm calling as a domains, they're going to be rotated in the presence of alternating magnetic field. So due to that, what is going to be happen? There is a change in length. This change in length, this vibrational produces ultrasonic waves. When the rod is going to be vibrate, it is produces ultrasonic waves. So now we are in a position to give the answer. The ultrasound can be produced by piezoelectric effects and magnetostriction method. Now you may get the doubt, sir, how much length change? The length change is minute, is in terms of millimeters range. Okay, now I'll go for the next. So we know that we can produce ultrasonic waves. Now my question is, how to detect ultrasonic waves? Please think. I'm launching the polling. Please look at the answer. Try to give that. How to detect the ultrasonic waves? Please give the response. The bar is toggling between A and B, not infrared sensor, baro sensor. The options are lying from A and B. How to detect ultrasonic waves? How to detect ultrasonic waves? My question is related to the detection, not with respect to the production. My question is related to the detection of ultrasonic waves, but not the production. So as of now, 750 people have responded out of 1,000. Okay, fine. So everyone responded. I'm ending the polling. I'll try to give the answer. Here, the most of the people, 50% people given option B. The ultrasonic waves can be produced only using inverse piezoelectric effect, but the detection can be done by piezoelectric effect. The answer is piezoelectric effect. Why? Because in the case of piezoelectric effect, look at this. When you're passing the ultrasonic waves in this direction, this mechanical axis, so the charges are going to be produced in other direction. So due to these charges, we are able to detect their ultrasonic waves. I hope you understood the concept. So the ultrasonic waves can be detected by piezoelectric effect. Production is inverse piezoelectric effect. Okay, now. So the answer is piezoelectric effect. Let me see the applications of ultrasonic waves in different fields. I'll try to cover the number of applications in different fields. There are a lot of applications are there, but I'm focusing about only one particular or five areas I'm focusing. The first point is, can we mix oil and water? Please give me your answer in the Q&A. Can we mix oil and water? Oh, some people say yes. Can we mix oil and water? Someone said quench tube. Okay, very good for the detection. Very good. Understood. You are very good at concept. Quench tube, sensitive flame method can be used to produce. Yes. No. So we cannot mix oil and water. Practically, we can see now. But how to mix it? How to mix oil and water? Because oil is a non-polar, water is a polar. So the polar material, water contains hydrogen bonds. So oil does not contain the hydrogen bond, so that it cannot mix. How to mix it? You have to apply certain pressure or vary the temperature. Here, even though apply the temperature or some little bit pressure, we cannot mix. So due to the process of emulsification, this process is set to the emulsification. When ultrasonic waves propagating through this particular immiscible liquids, so the oil and water get collapse. So due to that, there is going to be mix. This is said to be the emulsifier. This emulsifier can be used for different purposes in the chemical industry or paint industry. So let me see this particular video to understand the concept. Try to look at this video. This is an ultrasonic probe. So the oil and water can be mixed by means of the ultrasonic transducer technique. There is a probe which produces the ultrasonic waves due to the higher pressure. So they are going to be propagated in the medium. So due to this propagation, the high pressures within the medium causes the mix of oil and water. So let me look at the next application of ultrasonic waves. So the use of emulsification, especially for the pharmaceutical industry, these tablets or medicines are more palatable, means it is a sweetener. So in this, they are pouring certain amount the materials, the organic substances, which are not mixable. So they are using especially the ultrasonic emulsification, and also to control the dosage activities and ingredients in the material. How to activate and control that can be done by ultrasonic emulsification process. Especially in the agricultural industry, there are certain pesticides, the biocides, which cannot be dissolved in a water. Water insoluble pesticides. So there we are using this particular, the ultrasonic emulsification, and the minute power level we have to dose that can be used for crops. And one more important point here, paint industry. So if you suppose you want to make the a particular color, you are going to the paint shop, you are selecting the primary colors. If you observe carefully in the paint shop, that person will mix primary colors in one of the primary one of the color, then the complete box they put it under certain box, then it's operated for a few seconds so that the coat, that complete the mixing of the colors, it produces one color. Mixing of two primary colors produces one color. That can be done by using by the ultrasonic emulsification process. I'm so fascinated that when I went to the paint shop, so I need particular color, that fellow has taken one white color, then added certain thing, then put it in the box. He operated for 1.5 minutes. Finally, the particular color has come. How the mixing done properly? That is only with respect to the ultrasonic emulsification. The next concept is non-destructive testing. The meaning of non-destructive testing is without spoiling any material, we are studying the properties from externally. Let me give an example. A wall is manufactured, in that they use a perfect steel or some other materials. I would like to see what is the composition that contractor has mixed. I cannot completely break out. I can see that this is manufactured, so that I can see this is the percentage. So how can I test without spoiling the wall? I have to use certain mechanism. That mechanism is nothing but non-destructive testing. Here I'm passing the ultrasonic waves through a material. Some part of the energy is transmitted and some part of the energy is reflected. So based on the reflected signal, we can able to see that, okay, there is not, the composition is not that much purity level, or there is a fracture, there may be the flaws in the material. Especially this non-destructive testing is useful in the mechanical industry. Here I'm going to show this. Look at this animation. This is an ultrasonic transducer. This is the input one. We'll get the input intensity and the reflector from the last end. So you're getting the two peaks. One is input end, other one is the echo. Look at the figure carefully. The input, we are getting one. At the end, by reflection, we are getting one more. There is an echo. The two peaks are there. Now, if there is any fracture, it may be any flaws. Look at this. In between, you are getting the crack. By this mechanism, we are able to say there is a flaws in the material. This is said to be the ultrasonic non-destructive testing. Especially for the aviation industry, they are checking any flaws in by using this particular technique. Here I'm trying to show one more animation. Look at this. One technical engineer is allowing the ultrasonic waves through the a solid material. Wherever the fractures or flaws, any defects, that can be easily monitored by using ultrasonic waves. Look at this. Now the best beauty of this particular thing is the person is able to identify where is exactly the location, how much flaw, what is the thickness of the flaw. All the things can be monitored by using non-destructive evaluation methods. I hope you understood this concept. The next part is I've taken the glass, I want to make a drill, right? This is the drilling bit generally we use. For metals, easily you can go for drilling, but I'm concerned about the glasses. I'm concerned about the plastics. I'm concerned about ceramics. How can I go for drilling? I want to go for drill for the diamond, which is a hard material. How can I do it? So this bit cannot be used for the drilling purpose. What is you have to use? You have to go for ultrasonic drilling. So the ultrasonic drilling is usable for glasses, plastic composites, ceramics. Here I'll try to show a drilling animation video which is collected from the Open Education Resources from MIT website. It consists of a piezoelectric, like a tool bit, which is going to be vibrate, which is going to be vibrate. There is a slurry which is coated on this to make the impact of coupling the ultrasonic waves through the metal surface. A slurry which is used for the coupling of the ultrasonic waves through the material. Here, the slurry may use silicone grease or maybe viscous concept. They may use the viscous liquids, maybe glycerin or somewhat oils also they're using. So let me see the video of this. He has taken the hard material. Let's see how the drilling is going to be done.
Eight millimeters.
Okay, he is using carborundum, a grease, which is couples the ultrasonic waves to the material. See, look at that, the drilling has done. So the ultrasonics can be also used for the drilling of movement. Okay, now let me go for the next slide. What is meant by welding? Generally, when you observe a localities, when person is going to be weld the two different materials joining, this is set up the hot welding. This is set up the hot welding. But my intention is I want to make a plastic, maybe the plastic on the glass or glass on the plastic or plastic on the metal material. So what happens, especially in this case, this welding produces the heating effect more. So it may, the two different materials may be melted due to the higher temperature. So there is a restriction for me. So in that case, especially for the plastic materials, maybe the glass materials I want to join together, I cannot use this particular welding, hot welding. I'm using the concept called ultrasonic welding. This is set up the cold welding. This is set up the cold, which cannot produce any heat and harmful gases. Very simple logic. I've taken the two different materials I want to join together. When ultrasonic waves are propagating, try to think in a simple manner. A void is there. Let me see, the void is in the B material, whereas the A is want to diffuse. So when you're passing the ultrasonic waves, this particles of A is going to be diffused into the second particle. So due to this, what happened? There is a bonding is developed. So by passing high frequency waves through the material, there is a diffusion of molecules into the other material. It causes the joint. That is said to be the ultrasonic welding. Especially this ultrasonic welding is usable for mechanical industry, the car manufacturing. Please watch this video for the better understanding of the concept.
In cars, wiring harnesses transport signals and electric current. Up to 6 kilometers of cable can be installed in a modern vehicle. They ensure that the car starts, that the headlights work, and that tire pressure is displayed on the onboard computer. The connections among these innumerable cables must be perfect in order to function perfectly over the entire lifetime of the car. For this reason, ultrasonic metal welding is the method of choice for fixed and durable cable connections.
So by using this procedure, so you can weld two different materials.
The energy required to connect metals is achieved with extremely fast vibration, ultrasonic frequencies. Shunk is the glove.
So I hope you understood the concept, the ultrasonic welding, this is a cold welding. The next part, soldering. Suppose in general, in electronic circuits, we are using this particular soldering rod. Okay, it is going to work for the copper. But my interest is, I want to make soldering on the glass material or aluminium, because aluminium cannot be soldered using this particular methods. Now, how to do this? The aluminium easily forms oxide layer which cannot be welded. So at the time, I'm preferring the ultrasonic welding, because this ultrasonic welding, the aluminium oxide layer can be removed by this particular pressure waves, so it is going to weld together. Is it clear to you? So the ultrasonic welding, ultrasonic soldering, this ultrasonic soldering can be done on the glass plate or any other material. Look at this particular video. This video clearly demonstrates the ultrasonic soldering on the glass plate. Please watch to me. Someone asked the question, this ultrasonic soldering is worked for all the cases. Look at this. He's trying to connect the copper wire on the glass. Try to observe carefully. Even though he's applying the larger force, the soldering cannot be removed, which is a tight soldering. The device he is using is that hot welding. First one is the solder, which is a piezoelectric soldering gun. You're able to sense the noise, that is a piezoelectric, which crystal is vibrating. I'll share this video link once the class completes on YouTube channel. Yes, look at this. It pulls like anything, still so tough. So this is the ultrasonic soldering. Especially for the research, they're using this particular soldering mechanism, especially on the PCB boards also, they're using this. So let me go for the next point, the ultrasonic cutting, especially for the rubbers or the cement slabs, can be cut using the ultrasonic cutting machine. Please watch the video and enjoy. We cannot crop like using blade, that much smooth. Even the CD also, we cannot cut like this by using the ordinary knife. Okay, look at this video. This is a cement slab, it's going to cut by uniformly. Ultrasonic cutting can be used. The next part I'm going to show is ultrasonic cleaning. Especially when you're giving a car or any vehicle to the service point of view, this the engine parts is consist of lot of dust, maybe the oil. I want to clean properly, especially when you're going for watches. They want to clean inside. They cannot clean with respect to taking the water just like that. They're using particular mechanisms called ultrasonic cleaning. Especially for the dry cleaning of the cloths also, we are using this particular method called ultrasonic cleaning, and just watch the video. I'll demonstrate this particular video once you come to the class. There is a facilities available here. I'll try to do in front of the students so that they can understand the concept clearly. You try to demonstrate all this content of the concepts in the classroom, in the live mode. Here I'm using the word ultrasonic cavitation. The meaning of ultrasonic cavitation is when ultrasonic waves is propagating through the medium, so it produces a cavity. It means more pressurized waves are produces in the water medium, which produces more heat. Look at this. Completely cleaning is done. So this is the way the ultrasonic cleaning of engine parts can be done, especially in the service centers. Now let me go for the dentist. The plaque removal on the teeth can be done using ultrasonic device. Please watch the video. But this is the mechanism that can be used to remove the plate on the teeth. The ultrasonic device can be used to remove the teeth also. Initial days, the doctors used to use the cutting player to remove the teeth. Now we are using this particular ultrasonic device. It can produce the vibrations exactly at the root level, easily can remove. Okay, the next point, the sonar. You know about the sonar very well, you studied in the intermediate on basic level. Sound navigation and ranging. Here we're sending the ultrasonic waves, the sound waves is going to penetrate to the water maximum level, then reflected back. The distance traveled by the ultrasonic waves is d plus d 2d. If you use the concept, the speed is equal to distance by time. V is the speed, distance is 2D, the time taken is T. So with respect to that, we are in a position to find out the depth of the sea. And also by using the Doppler effect, we are in a position to identify the position of the submarines also. Especially when the movie Ghazi attack, they're using one radar, which is an ultrasonic radar. It produces the ultrasonic sound. It gets reflected from the object. By using the change of frequency, it's called Doppler effect. By using this mechanism, we're in a position to calculate the position of the submarine under the sea. The speed is equal to distance by time. The distance is 2 times of d. So v is equal to 2d by t. So here in the quiz, I have given certain questions based on this particular formula. Please try to attend the quiz. The next part is, this ultrasound scan can be usable for this particular purpose. The person who is doing this particular mechanism, they are said to be the sonographers. When an ultrasound wave is passing through the pregnant woman, so what are the parameters you can get from this? You can see that the baby position, all the parts are formed properly or not. And you can check the baby position.
respiration, the movement, the breathing rate and breathing levels and heartbeat. So how many number of fetus are formed, especially this is said to be the ultrasound scan. When you go to the hospital, so you can see this particular technique for especially for the pregnant ladies. Now my question comes to you. Yesterday you discussed about MRI, magnetic resonance imaging. Why do doctors prefer X-rays compared to the ultrasound scan? What is the advantages of ultrasound scan? What are the disadvantages? Then what are the advantages of X-ray scan and the disadvantages? I have given one question in the assignment. Please try to answer that question. So this is nothing but ultrasound scan. Here I am trying to show the image, the 2D image, 3D and 4D. Look at this. Hope enjoy the video. The two-dimensional. This shows the heartbeat. All the organs are properly formed or not in the case of 2D. It's a black and white. Now let me look at the 3D. X, Y, Z axis. It gives the volume of the baby. Means volume. The movement direction. The picture is still more. The 4D is nothing but it gives the signal with respect to the time scale. You can see the baby position, the baby laughs, baby cries, it can move inside. Right? You can see the position of the baby. Okay. So the next part is, especially in your houses, we are using vibration meter. It's called a vibration device. It's nothing but ultrasonic. Especially when you feel the neck pain or any pains, the muscle pains, that can be relieved easily by using this particular mechanism, the ultrasound therapeutic applications. What happens especially here, this ultrasound waves crossing to the particular tissue. So local heat is produced. It may be stretches or it may be the relieves the pain there. So to remove the pain, we are using this particular therapeutic applications using ultrasound. It means it mobilizes the tissues in that particular area. So the same thing, this ultrasound can be also be used for the blind person. It having the blind stick, it produces the ultrasonic waves. It gets deflected from the object. Once it gets deflected, he may give the echo that is converted to electrical pulse so that it produces the sound in the eardrum of electronic devices. So by using this particular mechanism, the blind person can able to see that the assess, there is an object is there in front of him. Similarly, the blood flow meter, the same concept using the Doppler effect, we can find out the blood flow level. Now I want to discuss one important point here, especially in the Maharashtra, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh region, the 46,000 farmers and students get, okay, the 46,000, they got died because of this snake attacks, especially in the Maharashtra region, in the tribal villages. When the snake bites, there is no medical facilities available like making anti this venom or ambulances. High poisonous. So one of the person is a computer engineer from Bangalore. He looked at all the issues. He started making one particular smart device, which is said to be the ultrasonic stick. This is the ultrasonic stick. It is fabricated. It is published in the Better India. I provide the link here. Try to go through the link. The Better India concept. He has done this particular thing, and 90%. It reduces the snake bites. What the logic here? This snake stick, okay, this ultrasonic stick produces the pulses. It can pass into certain distances. Wherever the snake is there, it can sense through this skin. The snake sense through the skin so that that particular places the skin doesn't come. Like this, all the farmers, especially the farmers, they're carrying this particular ultrasonic stick. Wherever they are working, just putting into the soil up to certain feet, then they are doing work. And similarly, in the school, primary schools, the small children, they're going to come to the classes. So in that case also, that faculty, this particular people, they're given this particular sticks. So they're sticking, they're just putting into the ground, maybe 10, 15 around the school, so that no snake coming into that region. So this is what they have done. So the person is computer science engineer, but he's seeing the practical difficulty, then solve the problem. Don't think that I'm a computer science engineer, I cannot do this. So our technology has to go to the farmers, go to the society. Then only our study is going to be helpful. So I'm keeping one more question here. Try to think. These are the references for the topic, what I collected. Engineering Physics by Avadhanalu. I collected some of the different materials. These are the quiz links I'm trying to post you. Try to attend this and try to give the quiz link and assignment and feedback on the session so that I can improve. This is the question I'm trying to keep in front of you. Please think of, especially in the Srikakulam district, Orissa, these elephants are destroying the crops. Recently, I have seen the video, the farmer is crying like anything. A mob of 100 elephants directly came to the crops, they completely spoiled. How can we stop these elephants from destroying the crops? Please try to think. Please try to think the answer for this. This is the way your study is useful for the society point of view. Please try to think. We have submitted this particular project in the Telangana Innovative Cell. It's under consideration. We're trying to do this. Please try to do this. Try to think. Once you come to the campus, I'll try to show this particular demonstration, how these elephants protect from the destroying the crops. Thank you. I'm trying to post the questions to you now, the quiz questions in the chat box. Please give me the answers as early as possible. All the participants, please try to give this quizzes and assignments. If you have any doubts, you can drop a mail to me so that I can respond.